Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, whatever time of day you're joining us for the daily message, thank you. My name is Beth Rayom, and I've been a parishioner at St. Nicholas for almost 25 years. And I am so blessed to have the opportunity to work with our Catechesis of the Good Shepherd program. Today, I'm going to tell you about how I'm using one of my favorite works in the atrium as my Lenten reflection. One of the topics of study that we have in each of our atria is the plan of God, and it takes many shapes and forms for each of our age groups. It's sometimes referred to as the blue strip or the gift strip or the history of the kingdom of God. But the general concept is this. There are three critical moments in the plan of God. The first is creation, which is a story that we've all heard many times about how God created this beautiful world, filled it with abundant gifts, and gave humankind dominion over all of it. In the second moment, redemption, God gave us the greatest gift of all, the gift of his son Jesus. Jesus, while he was with us, taught the disciples about the kingdom of God, and he used parables and stories and performed miracles to teach them about what it was like to be a part of that kingdom. And if we could all follow those teachings that Jesus shared with us, then we'd reach the third moment, the parousia. The parousia is a wonderful moment when God is all in all. Everything is as perfect as we could possibly imagine, and we're all living in peace and enjoying a wonderful banquet. We are not quite to the parousia yet. We call the time that we're living in right now the blank page. And the blank page is just that. It's an empty page on which humankind is writing our contributions to the plan of God. Some of the things that we do are truly amazing, and they bring us closer and closer to the parousia. And some of the things that we do don't get us there quite yet. We're not living according to the way that Jesus taught us. This Lent, I'm reflecting on my own blank page and my contributions to the plan of God. What are the ways that I am living to my fullest potential? That I'm using the gifts that God gave me to make our world a better place filled with joy, that I'm being kind to my neighbor and taking care of our beautiful planet. And what are some of the ways that I need to improve, areas where I'm struggling, where my thoughts and my actions are preventing me from fully accepting that invitation? This Lent, I'm praying that God helps me keep my heart open and be aware of how I'm writing my page. And I know that no matter where you are in your Lenten reflection, he's doing the same for you. Thank you so much for joining me, and have a wonderful day.